I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today's concept about the Mohr circle. This is the problem they are given it. This is the tensile stress they have mentioned it. This is the compressive stress. This is nothing but a shear stress. First, I will consider if this one, if the arrows are away from each other, I will consider the positive. Towards, I will consider as a negative. If the shear rotating in this direction, positive. Anti-clockwise direction, negative. Now, first I will write sigma x and tau. Now, sigma x, this is tensile tension, therefore plus 60. Tau, it is rotating in clockwise direction, therefore it is plus 10. Complete it. Next here, again I will write here sigma y and tau. Sigma y value is 40 in compression, but it is minus 40 compression. Minus 40. What is tau? It is rotating in anti-clockwise. Therefore, again 10. This completes your first portion. And then I will draw the line here, xy line. This is tau positive. Tau, this is tau negative, sigma positive, sigma negative. Now, based upon above figure, sigma x 60 newton per mm square. Therefore, from O you have to go for, and before this one go for the scale. I will consider the scale 1 centimeter is equal to 10 newton per mm square. 10 newton per mm square. From this point, I will go for 6 centimeter. This is 6 centimeter. This is my 6 centimeter. Now, next, toe is 10 positive. 10 is nothing but 1 centimeter. Here, 90 degree, exactly 90 degree. This is A. And this is D. First portion is completed. Next, from the figure, minus 40. From O, it is minus 40. This side is minus 40. This is B. Minus 10. Minus 10 is bottom. This is minus sign. This is minus sign. Therefore, minus 10 bottom. You have to write it little bit bottom here. Okay, write it little bit bottom. 10. This is A. Join to this point and this point. You have to join it out. This is your midpoint. Little bit, you have to locate the midpoint exactly because it is reaching here. Now draw the line. This is the midpoint here. This is the midpoint. Now this part sigma max, this part sigma mean. From the midpoint, this is C. From the C, draw a line which goes inside this circle, and this point act as a sigma max, and this point act as a sigma mean. Just calculate the value directly with the help of the scale. If you measure from O, you have to measure from the O, it will be 61 newton per mm square. 61 newton, that means 6.1 into 10, you can do it, you will get the 61 newton per mm square. Similarly for this part, it is 41 newton per mm square, that means 4.1 into 10, you will get 41 newton per mm square. This is the maximum shear stress, it is 51 newton per mm square. This is also 51 newton per mm square. Now we have to go for finding the location of principal plane. Location of principal plane. Now I will consider this direction from this to this 2 theta 1. If you count it, if you measure it, it will be exactly 10 or 11. If you measure it, it will be exactly, if you measure it properly, it will exactly 10 here, but in my negative direction. If you take it this way, no problem. If you have to move anti-clockwise, go for it. Otherwise, if the line has to be located near, because we are locating the location of the principal plane, therefore draw in this way. Otherwise, you have to bring this arrow till here, till this plane, then you have to go for theta 1. This also no problem. Okay, 2 theta 1 is nothing but 10 degree. Now theta 1 is nothing but what? 5. Next formula is nothing but theta 2 is nothing but what? Theta 1 plus 90. What is theta 1? 5 plus 90. 5 plus 90. One thing here. I have taken in the negative direction. This is negative. Therefore, I have to write as a minus 10. Minus 5. And minus 5 is equal to minus 90 is nothing but 85 degree, because I have taken negative direction. If you want to take it in this way, no problem, you can take it, because the principal plane is near to this one, therefore I have taken in negative direction. 2 theta is minus 10 degree, theta is nothing minus 5, 2 theta is nothing but theta 1 plus 90, minus 5 plus 90, 85 degree. Now location of shear stress plane. Formula for this one, theta 3 is nothing but 1 by 2, 2 theta 1 plus 90. What is 2 theta 1? 1 by 2 minus 10 plus 90. Minus 10 plus 90. If you calculate, the value will be 40 degree. Similarly, theta 4 will be 1 by 2, 2 theta 1 plus 270 is the formula. 1 by 2 minus 10 plus 270. If you calculate the value, you will get 130 degrees the angle. Now, first locate the principal plane. First is already done. Second, from this part to this part, we call as a 2 theta 2. These are the plane, principal plane. Now stresses, this part to this part, we call it the shear stress, 2 theta 3. One more, from this part to this part, we call it as a 2 theta 4. I am Santosh Gadinkar.